13 dead in gun and gangland crime in Limerick in the past 80 years, and there's no sign of it stopping. The two latest killings mark not only a worrying escalation in this ongoing familial criminal feud, they may also draw two more family factions into the murderous cycle of violence.
It has gone so bad now, and the feud here is so vicious, that these people are turning on one another, and people who are part of the same gangs, for their own reasons and their paranoia, are shooting one another.
It all started in 2000 with tit-for-tat killings between the Ryans and the Keanes. Eddie Ryan first, Kieran Keane in retaliation. The families, once allies, fell out over the control of the region's drugs trade. In 2003, the other families got involved, the Colopies on the Keane side, the McCarthy Dundons on the Ryan side. Since then, eight others have died in the feud. Three more have also been murdered because they crossed or stood up to the gangs, including the doorman, Brian Fitzgerald, and the car thief, Richard Happy Kelly. The Limerick feud is particularly bad because it's not just about the drugs business, it's personal. The gang members hate each other. They hate each other's families and anyone connected or related to the other side. Many of the key figures are in prison, but they're still directing their operations from behind bars. Gardaí believe the release of Gerard Dundon recently has contributed to these latest tensions, and they're expected to get far worse when Wayne Dundon and Christy Keane are freed.
The culture that's demonstrated here is utterly deplorable, and the Gardaí have to deal with it by speedily investigating what's happening and bringing those involved to justice.
The bitterness is now so entrenched that the families have actually fought in the city's hospital. The women at a school nativity play last Christmas, the children in the schoolyard. The feud is being handed on to the next generation and spreading out to extended family members, criminal associates and new criminal families. It's now only a matter of time before the 14th person is murdered. Paul Reynolds, RTE News, Dublin.